made available is of eternal inheritance. That means they can inherit. That is not just only written in the pages of the books as a testament, as an intention of God. It has moved from that and is now an active and living testament because the testator has died. Jesus died to activate, give life to the testament, to the principles, to the intentions that God had before the foundations of the earth for mankind. Hallelujah. We're still reading verse 18. Whereupon, neither the first testament was dedicated without blood. So that first testament was dedicated with blood. Look at it, verse 19. For when Moses had spoken every precept to all the people according to the law, he took the blood of calves and of goats with water and scarlet wool and hyssop and sprinkled both the book and all the people. You see, Moses had to sprinkle the book and the people to sanctify, to clear it up, to more or less make it sacred. He had to do that. Moses did that, and it was with an inferior blood. Now you have not been sprinkled upon. You have been dipped, immersed in the blood of Christ. The that was unlocked in the Old Testament by the prophets and the people, that they did the impossible, did great things, were able to stop the mouth of lions, were able to stop sun from moving, were able to do all kinds of things, daring the impossible, doing the unbelievable. Those people with an insane blood were able to achieve that. How much more? You not just being sprinkled, but you being immersed, dipped into the blood of Christ, to believe that every eternal inheritance, everything written in the book, everything written about you must be fulfilled, because it's an eternal inheritance that has already been paid for once and for all. So I have a blood bought right. You have a blood bought right to believe what God has already done, to lay claim the precepts that have been written. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Let me digress a little and just say this. Please understand that for everyone that has a will in state, that will is available. If the person that wrote the will is still alive, will means that you own 5 houses in Banana Island, but you can't lay hold on it. You can't take possession because it's not yet active. But when the testator, the one who wrote the will, dies, and they read the will, they legally read the will, it becomes effective that which was already the intention of the writer is now made manifest, and there is a reality. And look now, based on the reading of the will, based on the reading of the will, you can lay claim and say the 5,000 in Black Island with my name, so I lay hold on it. But if you do not read the will, you will not know what is available to you, because the will, even though the testator has died, there is a necessity for the will, for the testament to be read, so that when it is read, you can come into a consciousness of what is available to you, and thereby hold on your inheritance. Hallelujah. Glory to God. If you understand where I'm going, I'm saying that one of the things that we need to do, especially at this time, is to understand that there is a necessity to go into the Word of God, dig deep, finding out the miracles, the inheritances that have already been given to us with our names on it. Every promise according to the Word of God is already been stamped with a yea and amen. Yes, but the amen is said by us. Hallelujah, glory to God. The amen is said by us. If we let go and just think Easter is just a celebration that Jesus died, we will not have been able to read the will and really hold on the things that have been freely given to us. Hallelujah. But as we read, which is what we're doing right now, prosperity, in health,
supposed to just click into browser that you can use.
Of heaven.
We don't need to download.
But we are still going on. Let's move on. Verse 20. Saying, this is the blood of the testament which God hath enjoined unto you. So here was Moses taking the blood of calves and of this is the blood of the testament which God has enjoined with unto us. Because he said it, he became active instantaneously, because the death of the testator had already been done. Those animals stood in as testators, and so now it was now active already. And this was of a lesser blood. Brother, sprinkled with blood, both the tabernacle and all the vessels of ministry. Okay. So this was a blood bath, more or less a blood bath. Why did the blood bath to sanctify all things, so that things could be used to the glory of God? So even when you are taking the utensil, it's already been sanctified, set apart, made sacred unto God. You are going to sit on it and sanctify, set apart, made ready for God. You are entering into the tabernacle, sacred unto God. You yourself are sanctified, set apart, sacred unto God. And that was what was available even in the Old Testament. Of goats was what was available. It was the funness. I mustn't jump. So verse 21 says, moreover, I sprinkle both blood and all the vessels of the ministry. And all things are by the law washed with blood. And with the shedding of blood is no remission. So here was Moses trying to make sure that everything, objects, he cleansed and sanctified to make sure there was no legal right of refusal where collecting whatever was available in the testament was concerned. You see, God promised the Israelites, when he said that if you obey me, I will bless your bread and water, and I will take sicknesses from the midst of thee. If you obey me and serve me, he had said that. He had spoken and said that thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all that. So he had said all kinds of things to the Israelites. But here, Moses wanted to make sure that nothing was holding them down. The blood was shed for redemption.